Welcome to a new Helen's Take On video. Today, I want to show you how you can make the same change in several places inside your class with multiple carets. That change might be at the start of several lines, in the middle of the lines, or at the end of the lines. Let's say we want to prefix all these strings with private final. On a Mac, press Option twice, holding it down the second time. And if you're on Windows or Linux, press Control twice, holding it down the second time. And then you can use your arrow keys to generate additional carets. Now we can type in private final and then press escape to go back to our single primary caret. How about this Java dot comment here on line 3? Perhaps we want to render it as a bulleted list using HTML tags. We can use the same shortcut again, so Option for Mac or Control for Windows, pressing it twice, holding it down the second time, and then use our arrow keys to generate multiple carets. We can type in our list item tag, and IntelliJ IDEA gives us the closing tag as well. However, we're going to cut it from there and paste it to the end of our line. Now, when we render our java.comment, it's a nice bulleted list. If you've ever participated in coding challenges, you might well have pasted a long list of data into your class. Something like this, perhaps. We can solve this one easily using the same shortcut again. We can remove those extra spaces and add the comma, and then press escape to return to our primary caret. So what about creating multiple carets at the end of the line? There are a couple of ways you can do this. It is a similar process. First, you can position your primary caret anywhere on the line, and then on a Mac, you're going to press Option twice, holding it down the second time. But if you're using Windows, it's Alt twice, holding it down the second time. But this time, instead of using your arrow keys, you can use your mouse or your trackpad to drag the cursor down, keeping it to the right of the end of your lines. The second way that you can do this is to select the code where you want multiple carets at the end of your lines, and then use Option Shift and G on Mac or Alt Shift and G on Windows and Linux. And you'll get multiple carets at the end of your lines that way as well. What about if you want multiple carets at different points in your code? On a Mac, you can hold down Option and Shift and then click where you want to place a caret. For Windows, it's Alt and Shift and then click where you want to place a caret. This is really helpful if you want to make the same change in a number of places, but they're not necessarily sequential. You can also remove carets using the same shortcut again. So Option and Shift for Mac or Alt and Shift for Windows and then click and that will remove a caret. You can't remove your primary caret. So when you press escape, IntelliJ IDEA will take you back to that primary caret. Now, all the ways I've shown you so far, add the carets as the last character position in the target line or at the start of your target line. However, IntelliJ IDEA also has column select mode, which you can turn on and off. And this allows you to add new carets anywhere in after the last character in your line. As soon as you start typing in a position beyond the end of the line, IntelliJ IDEA will add the necessary spaces between the end of your line and the beginning of your new input. So you can turn column select mode on with Shift Command and 8 on Mac, or Alt Shift and Insert on Windows and Linux, or you can search for it with Find Actions, so Command Shift and A or Control Shift and A. You can then hold down Shift and use the arrow keys to create multiple carets, or again, if you want to use your mouse, you can just drag your mouse straight down or up to create that column of carets. So that's it. I hope that was useful, and thanks for watching.